So, well, even if you don't know exactly what you're going to do, let's do something that you can do. What is something you can do? Let me just make sure we do it correctly. Okay, distributed property. Let's go for it.
Good job.
Alright, so negative 3 times 6, negative 18. Negative 3 times negative 2, plus 16. Alright. So always try it. See if it gets simpler.
You could add 18 to both sides.
Add 18 to both sides.
Good job.
That's something you could do. Alright, so that's 5, 3, 4, 45 equals 3c plus 6c. What is the word? What's the word? What? The like term. The like term. So 9c equals 45. The next?
You divide 45 by
9. Right, you divide both sides.
Okay.
Good job.
Let's look at this real quick, because I think in my other algebra class, it's not an uncommon thing to struggle with. You don't quite understand why divided by 9 cancels mm-hmm. something out.
Just, it makes the C just 1, so then, so when you divide, 45 by 9, you get 5, and then over there you have 1c, so you multiply 5 times 1c.
Multiply 5 by 1c?
Well,
you can't do that.
It's just equal.
It's equal
to 1.
Yeah. The thing, yeah, I mean, you're right about all that stuff. It's just that when this happens, I think the reason why it works is a little too magical. So I just want to make this clear. Here's the reason why. It's because 9 is dividing itself. Jane?
I was going to say 9 divided by 9 is 1, and 1 times c is c. So.
Yes. So it's just a matter of seeing that is, like, legal, you know, that it is. It is 9 over 9 times c, isn't it?
Yeah.
9c over 9 is the same as 9 over 9 times c. Can anybody justify that? Prove that is the case? How so? How can you, Jenna, can you convince me that this is the same as that?
Because 9 divided by 9 equals 1, and then every variable has a 1 underneath. So over 1.
I think you're saying that, like, you're assuming that you already know that 9 cancels with 9, and 9 over 9 is 1, 1 times c. I'm saying, how do I know that 9c divided by 9 is the same as 9 over 9 times c over 1? Without saying, well, if I divide 9 by 9, then I get c, and if I divide 9 by 9, I get 1c. I guess I'm just trying to review what it is we can do with fractions, how we manipulate fractions.
No.
Cross canceling would be like if this shared a factor with this guy here.
Yeah. No, I was
like, you thought it was 3, you know?
Well, if it was, but it's not. Did you want to take another crack at it?
Yeah, like if you multiply them together,
okay.
It's not.
How do you multiply fractions?
Across.
Straight across. Yeah, straight across. That's what I'm trying to get at. Is that 9 over 9, 9 divided by 9 is 1.
Yeah.
And 1 times c is c. This is definitely c. It's just a matter of, can I justify that this is the same as that? Yes, because if I were to multiply these two together, I multiply straight across and get 9c over 9 times 1 is 9. Right. So the reason why dividing by 9 gives you 1c is because 9 is dividing 9. Let's look at it as something that may look the same, but is not the same.
Of course.
5x plus 1, divide that by 5. Is that x plus 1?
No.
one plus one. It's one plus one.
Yeah.
It's one plus
yeah.
one.
I think.
Five x plus one over five is always two. One plus one is two.
Oh, okay.
No? Yes?
Yeah. That's cool.
One plus
one is two.
No. Put anything you want in there, correct? Probably won't be true. Like a seven. 35 plus 1 is 36. Over 5 is not 2. Right? That is not 2. Okay. Is that plus 1? Can I cancel the 5 with the 5?
Yes, you actually
yeah.
can.
Actually,
and
you cannot.
Well, you have to do that.
It doesn't
have
to be the same way.
Wouldn't you have to like multiply it to do that? Or
oh.
do the reciprocal?
Is it 10?
There's the rules.
Because you
I
divide 1 by
okay.
5 to all the terms.
So we started with, I didn't really do anything. All I've done, I wrote 5x plus 1 over 5. Okay, we started there. Can the 5s cancel?
No.
There is
not
an equal sign in the middle to like cancel on each side.
Because the other 5
are
5.
Because the other 5, like one's 5x and one's just regular
5. Boom!
Just.
Well, if I write 5x over 5, now the 5 cube cancel.
Oh.
Right? Just like with 9c over 9, like it just did. That is x.
Ooh.
Hmm.
Does the 1 get in the way? Because you can't really cancel it by all of them. You can just cancel it by 5x.
Yeah, that 1's getting in the way. How about x plus 1 fifth? Yes.
Yeah.
That is the case.
Oh, I get it.
And divided by 5, then remember, like when we, if this were one side of the equation, we have to divide the entire thing by 5, so we have to divide 5x and 1 by 5.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, be careful then. How about x plus 3 over 3? Is that x plus 1?
Oh.
Yeah, I think so.
Yes?
Yeah.
Would it be x over
3? Everything has to get divided by 3.
No.
Everything has to get divided by 3.
Oh,
division
and the 1 by
distributes across all terms just like multiplication does.
Because
this is really 1/3 times x plus 3. So everything has to get multiplied by 1/3. X over 3, 3 over 3. But what about 5x plus 10? Over 5? What's that?
That's x plus 2.
That's 5x.
That's x plus 2.
Oh.
That's x plus 2.
Oh, I got you.
On the 3 one? Thank you.
Good stop, though. Good stop.
Hey.
Yes.
Why is there, like, tumors in your wall?
I don't know. Question?
Okay. On the x plus 3 divided by 3, can
yes.
you just divide the 3s and then just add the 1x?
Add three,
divide them, into the like
these
numbers.
Ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did.
Oh.
So you divide by 3 is 1.
Oh, then you have to divide the x by 3 too.
Okay. Yeah, let's go on. Let's solve another equation. We've got 19. That wasn't. I don't have that one circled. Did I assign 19?
Yeah.
In 3.3.
Yeah.
Oh, confirmation.
No.
I got it right. Apparently, that's what you said.
19. I don't have 19 as a 3.3, but maybe a 3.4. All right.
Oh,
let's
yeah,
see.
Yeah.
20 now. 20. Okay. We have x minus 5 equals negative 6. Okay. Do anything legal? If it seems to make things difficult, maybe go back a few steps. Maybe it wasn't the best idea, but let's just do all ideas that we have, just make sure we do them legally. Maybe it was something we could do. I'm going to go through.
Distribute
what?
3 to everything inside the, or 3 over 2 to
3
every,
over 2.
Inside of the parentheses.
3 have the x.
Yeah.
What's next?
And then 3 times negative 5.
Okay. Tell me what I get. Do I get plus or minus something?
Minus?
Okay.
Yeah.
Minus what? What's that?
I don't know. I can't do that in my head.
just fractions, right? 5 over 1?
Uh-huh.
Straight across, multiply straight across.
15.
15.
Over 2.
There, you got it. Equals negative 6.
That was a good.
Wait,
was
I'm so confused.
What about what?
How would that be?
If you go 5 over 1.
No.
Real
let her ask her question.
I don't think it. Wouldn't you simplify that?
I thought that you meant like 15 over 2 equals negative 6.
Yeah, never mind.
Okay. You got 3 halves x minus 15 halves equals negative 6. Jennifer?
Would you add 15 over 2 to both sides?
That sounds great. That's like the, that's just the constant, right? You don't want the constant on this side. So we'll have 3 halves x equals, now we have negative 6 plus 15 halves. So we'll make this 12 halves. Right? Multiply by 2 over 2 to get a common denominator. 3 halves x equals negative 27 over 2. Okay? Jenna? Next?
You multiply by the reciprocal.
The reciprocal, love it. 3 divides 3, 2 divides 2. 2 over 3. 2 divides 2. Negative 27 divided by 3 is all that's left. Negative 9. Did anybody do anything differently, like from step 1?
I multiply by the reciprocal first.
I like that idea because then, well, watch it.
Good job, Timothy.
Because what happens is you get the fraction to cancel on this side, and then we multiply by 2/3 here. 3 cancels with negative 6, leaving us negative 2. And now we have no more fraction. We just have x minus 5 equals 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. Add 5 on both sides, x and 1. But what's going on?
Whoa.
Negative 2, 3, 5. There must have been something wrong over here. Oh, 15 halves minus 12 halves is not negative 7, 20. That's negative 27.
Oh, that's, yeah.
That's positive 3 halves.
I should.
So we're going to erase that.
No. Erase
wait.
That whole thing?
Yes. I want to erase that part.
It's
3.
3 halves.
Right.
Times 2/3. 2 cancels 2, 3 cancels 3. We have positive 1. So if you saw me do 15 halves minus 12 halves, it's negative 27 halves. I wish you would have said something before. All of us. Did you have something?
Oh, no, I'm just like
playing.
Okay. All right. Playing all
here. Let's see. Next, 24, 25. Do 24 real quick, but it will be quick. Because we have the experience of doing 20. It's very similar. Negative 14 equals 2/5 minus 2b. Okay. Can we distribute the 2/5? Yes, of course we can do that. But maybe Liz has given us another idea. Maybe we multiply by 5 halves before we even start.
So much easier.
1. Multiply by 5 halves on this side. Cancel this guy, we're left with negative 7. So negative 35 equals 9 minus 2b. Subtract 9. Negative 44 equals negative
2b.
22. 2b equals 22, and we divide both sides by negative 2. Be careful when you're supposed to divide by a negative. Remember, it's a sign. All right. That's 22. And now 25, 27. Okay, so we'll just follow along with this person and see what errors they made. Whoops. 6 equals 2. What did they do? They got 5x next. Negative 3x, does that seem to be all right? Would that be like the next step? Yeah? Negative 3 distributed to the x, okay?
That sounds all right.
We got minus 18, would that make sense?
No.
Why not?
Because if we then you take a negative plus, or a minus a negative.
Times.
Negative
plus.
Times a negative.
And it's a plus.
Yes. So that should be a plus. There it is. There's the problem, right? That's the problem.
Thank you.
For you. Right? Times.
Who's that talking?
Times.
Right?
What's up? Why you? Because he said times, right? Not plus, times. Alright, well, continue to solve. 5x minus 3x is 2x plus 18 equals 2. Subtract 18 on both sides. 2x equals negative 16, x equals negative 8. Divide by 2 on both sides. I got 27 and 32. They're incredibly similar. So which one should we do? 27.
32.
Okay, it's an opinion. All I need 32. It's just that it has decimals. You know,
cool.
Slightly different numbers. If we go back to 16, think about what we did first. What did we do first in number 16?
Distributive property.
Can we do the distributive property here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
With decimals.
Yeah, with decimals. So we just need to, you know, grab a calculator, negative 2.5 times 5.4, all this other stuff. And what's negative 2.5 times 5.4? It's negative. 13.5?
Oh, you should look at your paper.
Where's mine? All right. Just trust that you have that. Plus 2.5 times 6? 15m. Now what?
Now you would
add like terms.
Okay, add like
yeah,
terms.
3.5
like terms.
And 15.
Yep. So we get 18.5m minus 13.5.
Then you would plus
13.5. Okay, plus 13.5 on both sides.
Then you would go whatever that is.
Yeah, whatever that is. What is it?
22.2.
22.2. And what?
Divide.
Divide. 5? 18.5.
Yeah.
And what's 22.2 divided by
18.2?
0.2.
1.2.
1.2.
We
all agree?
You don't know.
Hey.
It's
a little nerve-wracking.
You're racking his nerves.
Yeah,
he's going to give you a negative A, bro.
Oh,
you should get a black A.
I want to get a gold A.
For negative?
No, for the best.
Oh,
gold
A.
You can only get golden eggs from that goose.
Oh.
Yeah, I got two.
Okay, I'll see if they have one.
I think they're on eBay,
though. Oh. Okay, so bad. Next. 3.4, number 4. No, variables on both sides.
Whoa.
To remind you how simple this is. Let me just treat you as a tour.
I thought of the gold thingy.
The gold thingy?
The balance.
Ah, that's the scale, yeah. I'm glad you did. Okay, so let's set up this equation on a set of scales. You got k, you got a single k, okay, plus 1, oh, that's 2, plus 1. And on this side we have 3k, 1, 2, 3k just represents an unknown amount, minus 1?
The black one.
The black one, or how about one that is floating, right, pushing changing up rather than them?
Oh yeah.
Is that okay? Like a helium filled form?
Well, I just want to mine.
Is that alright? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
It doesn't push down. It's up. Okay. Yes.
So you take a bag from each side?
Take one bag from each side.
AKA K.
What?
I'm really tired.
You're gonna take
okay
a coin on the right
off
and put a coin up on the left.
Okay, so I'll put a coin here. Right? What's a coin that pushes down and a coin that pushes up? What are they doing?
Equaling out.
They're equaling out. Okay, now I just need to do the same thing on the other side, which is put a coin on the top. Okay, I mean you can just.
So
it's easy to divide by two on both sides and see that one bag.
Each of them are one.
Each of them is one. Very clearly, because we, without even trying that hard, because it's so right in your face, we divide each side by two, group them into two groups. Two groups over here. Each group is over here. One group is a bag. Over here, one group is a coin. So one bag must be the same as one coin. So we do that here. The first thing we did, per Dimitri's instructions, is to take a bag off both sides, right? Minus k on both sides. And 1 equals 2k minus 1. And then what?
So that's when you add a coin to each side.
You add a coin to both sides, and the negative coin and the positive coin cancel each other out. We get
2.
2k. Divide by 2. 2k.
14.
K equals 0.
15, Mike.
Cancel them out?
Yeah.
How so?
Like,
oh, yeah.
You do minus k, and then you
subtract
from
the
other
side.
Minus
k?
So you would end up with 1 equals 2k,
and
not
at all. Isn't that what we have right here? 1 equals 2k minus 1? Okay. Let me make sure I understood this. Stop me if I go too fast, but I think we're done with that one. 14. Could be wrong. Just let me know. 5 times n plus 2 equals 3 fifths. Sure, let's do it. Double distributive property.
Oh,
so
cool.
Distribute the five. 5n plus 10. Again, we just distribute. We get 3 fifths times 5 is 3. And 3 fifths times 10 is 6. N. We set it up fraction, fraction, cross cancel, all that stuff. Yeah. Right now? Or previously? From this step or from the step before? This step? In this step, well, sort of. I mean, you don't have like terms on one side, right? Like
yeah,
we have n terms here and n terms here. So collecting like terms, kind of, like if we subtract 5n from this side, but collecting like terms implies like we're grouping them up. But in here we're taking some off of each side so that only one side is left with any of the variable. Right? It's like taking the bags off of both sides. So 3 plus n. Subtract from both sides, n is 7. Question?
That's what I.
You were going to say subtract from both sides. That worked out nicely. When we distribute that fraction, we actually, the denominator of 5 got canceled out. That worked out well. There we go, next one. Fast and 27 a little slow. I guess we'll say one more thing. Now what would you do? Just think of one.
Well, it's no solution,
mm-hmm.
because AC cannot equal AC plus 1.
Yeah. It's like saying 5 equals 5 plus 1. Is 5 equals 5 plus 1?
No.
That equals 5. Nothing, no number equals itself plus 1 more. Right? And it could, you know, number could equal itself times 1. But when you add 1, you change the number. Okay, so let's actually spend a couple of minutes on this. Bring this guy over again. See what that looks like. We got 8c on this side. 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll just double that. We have 8. And on this side, we have 8c as well, so I'll just copy this. Put it over there.
Oh,
gosh.
Oh.
All right, here we go. Try again. Okay, there we go. 8z plus 1. Just look at how physically impossible that would be. To put, remember, each bag is worth the exact same amount. So you put 8 bags here and 8 bags there. By just the very nature of these bags needing to be the exact same thing, that balances the scale.
Mm-hmm.
And
that was
sad
over there.
Yeah. Essentially, when we put 8 bags on both sides, we might as well have nothing. They're not, one is not doing anything to one side. So how is now 1 coin equal to nothing? That's not possible because 1 coin is 1 coin.
Right.
Right? It's not variable. It is 1. 1 coin has to be equal to 1 coin. You can't have 1 coin be equal to nothing. So the same thing would be like to subtract 8z from both sides, and 0 equals 1. That's what we found here, 0 equals 1. How often do you see 0 is equal to 1? Never, because how often is it true?
Never.
Never true. If we come back to this equation right here, we notice that a solution is a value for z that I can plug in, that makes the equation true. Is there anything you can plug into z that would make this equation true?
That's kind of hard,
no.
Impossible. Try to plug in 1, this is an easy one. 8 times 1. 8 equals 8 plus 1.
Nope.
8 does not equal 9. No matter what happens, you're gonna wind up with a number, and the same number here, and you're gonna say adding 1 to that number is the same as not doing anything to that number.
So big this.
Because that's never true. So if a solution is a value for z that I can plug in, how many values for z can I plug in that makes this equation true?
Zero
of them, not even the number zero, right? That doesn't work. So no
solution.
Negative zero.
Yeah, I was kind of confused.
Like, on 19 and 20, I got really confused. I didn't know what to do, like what else to do, because it just didn't make any sense to me.
You said 19 and 20?
Yeah, 19 and 20. But like...
So 20... It's just, we're done now, no solution.
Yeah, but
just
like,
the end.
I obviously got them wrong, it's just that I didn't know what, like, how to...
Oh, how to continue.
Continue it.
Okay. Yeah,
so
that is... So yeah, but it feels like you want to say, like, z is something, or some kind of statement like that. The only thing we can say is that...
I gotta try.
There are no solutions. Right? I've done all the work that I can do, and I've proven there is no value for z that can work. So there are no solutions. But, maybe we can contrast that with... 26, yes. 26 will be the opposite of that.
There is a solution.
And in fact, there's even more than one solution. Let's look at it. 26.
Maybe even more too.
Maybe. 2 times 3g plus 2 equals half times 12g plus 8. Distributive. 6g plus 4 equals 3. 1 half times 12, that's also the same. 1 half times, that's 4. Now just look at that. 6g plus 4 equals 6g plus 4.
Equals?
Yeah, of course it does.
Zero.
Identity.
It is an identity.
Because it's identical.
Both sides are identical. Yeah.
I learned that one.
Both sides are identical, so it's an identity. Yeah. It's like saying, it's kind of an analogy, but like, I ask you, you know, what's that thing out there? I say, what is that trailer out there? And you say, oh, it's that trailer out there.
Get that food service
trailer. You are 100% correct. Everything you just said is correct. But you didn't tell me anything about the trailer. You know what I'm saying? So to say 6G plus 4 is 6G plus 4, like, yeah, I know 6G plus 4, it's right there. But what about, what is G? Right, so the question is, what number works for G? Infinite number of solutions. Try it out. One. Will one work for G?
Yeah.
Yeah. It'll be 6 plus 4 equals 6 plus 4. How about 2?
Yeah.
12 plus 4 equals 12 plus 4. How about negative 5?
Oh, yeah.
Negative 30 plus 4 equals negative 30 plus 4. So no matter, here, let's kind of contrast it with this guy. No matter what I plug in for Z in this equation, it will never be true. No matter what I plug in here, it will never not be true. It will always be true. There's nothing I can do about the truth of this equation. I can't plug in the wrong value for G. I can never mess it up. Right? So, that's it. It's true. Always and forever. An infinite number of solutions. Okay. Now let's say you don't notice that. You don't say like, oh, both sides look exactly the same. Let's say you do all the normal algebra stuff and you come to some end. Let's see what happens here. Let's say I subtract 4 from both sides. 6g equals 6g. And then I'm going to get the variables together on one side. So subtract 6g. Subtract 6g. What do I get?
0.
0
equals
0. Equals 0. Now it might be something tempting to say g equals 0. That's what this says. It just says 0 equals 0.
I thought you divide.
Divide? You could divide by 6 and you can subtract g. You can still get 0 equals 0.
Yeah.
I can add 12 to both sides, 12 equals 12. I can multiply both sides by 5. No matter what I do, this is always true. Right? So if you do all this and all the variables cancel each other out and I just get something that's true, I have an infinite number of solutions or an identity. If I do all the work and it comes down to something that's false, then I have no solutions. Okay? Boil it all down, all the variables cancel each other out, and I get something false, no solution. Pull it all down, the variables cancel each other, I get something that's true, infinite solutions. Next is, what was that? That was 26, that was 27. The mistake one.
Distributive property,
3, and let's look at what they wrote. Okay, 3x plus 5 equals 3x. Plus 15. Is that correct?
Oh, that would be 3 times 5.
3 times 5 is
15.
15. Right? That would be the... I would get out my pen and I would say, no, that's not right. It's supposed to be 15. Okay. Is there something wrong
with it? Yes. Yeah. You got it.
Yeah, so it should have been 15, so instead of what they said, which is a no solution, is it still no solution, just by coincidence, or are there solutions?
There are identity.
It's an identity. How many solutions are there?
Infinite
number of solutions, since the both sides are identical. As soon as you see that, you know there's an infinite number of solutions. I was 27, now we're on 49. Ooh, I should get the snapshot.
Go with that.
We
should take
it
out.
Oh my gosh.
Dude, y'all, brother's last.
Don't play with the snapshots.
Wait, can I know it?
I just thought I didn't hear that right. I'm going to calculate.
So there's two different scenarios. You can either camp at this camping spot as a member of some camping association, so without being a member, or you can pay to be a member, and then when you go to a camping spot, it's cheaper to camp there per night. So, well, let's figure out what they want us to cost out. So it costs $45 to join. The local campground charges the members, so they pay the $45, they charge the members $35 per night. Non-members who didn't pay the $45, it charges them $40 per night. How many nights of camping and the total cost of members, including the membership fee, the same as the total cost of the non-members? So we say the same as, right? It's equal to. We've got the non-members, the members, however much they pay after so many nights, is the same.
So you, for the members, you pay the non-members. You'll have $45 because that's what they had the original case, and then plus $35, and then a little x site.
35 times x, and x represents what?
Nights.
The number of nights.
And that's equal to $40 times x, the number of nights.
So you start out by paying $45. There's nothing to do about that, you know. No matter how many nights you, if you camp zero nights, you still pay $45 to join that association, which is what they're hoping will happen, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Don't take advantage of the things that they offer, but you paid to be in the group. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you gotta be. This is exactly the kind of thing you want to think about when you think about joining some membership, right? So. Like maybe, sometimes gyms will let you just come in and use their stuff, but then they charge you more per day or more per hour to use their stuff. But if you pay lots of money and you join, then it's a lot cheaper every time you come. You just gotta think, if I gotta pay all that money, I need to come lots of times to make it worth it, right?
Yeah.
Worth it means overall you're gonna pay less.
Yeah.
Right now we're figuring out what is that base number of nights that I need to stay, so that I stay a little more than that, and I start paying less than a non-member over time. So just solving for that, find the number of nights. Some number of nights, I plug it in here, I plug it in here, I pay more per night here, less per night here, but I pay 45, and both sides come out to be the same. So you solve for x, and how do we solve for x?
Subtract 35x.
Okay, so 5x equals 45.
Five, five, five.
Five, five. X is 9 means what? X is 9 means what?
9 nights.
9 nights makes it so that what happens after 9 nights?
It's the same.
It's worth it.
Okay. It's worth it. Or at least if you break even. Even if I joined and I paid the 45, I paid the same as somebody who wasn't a member and stayed 9 nights.
It'll be the 9 nights. You see that over.
Yeah. So if you stay that 10th night, now you're saving money over that guy who didn't join and stayed 10 nights as well. It's a little bit tricky to write the left and the right side of the equation. That's the trickiest part. Writing that equation, solving it, that's not that easy. But writing it, realizing that I want to say that some like dollar amount for the non-members and the dollar amount for the members wants to be equal to each other. That just comes with practice. And we have one more? Which must be the other one problem?
Get to the chopper.
Yeah. 1, 32.
Double win.
$60, the rock climbing gym offers a yearly membership. This sounds familiar.
Oh, wow.
Membership, right?
Membership.
Okay, yearly membership $360 where members can climb as many days as they want and pay $4 a day for equipment, $4 per day for equipment rental. That's it. They only have to pay per day. Non-members pay $10 per day to use the gym, just to walk in the door, and $6 per day for equipment rental, which at a rock climbing gym, what kind of equipment would that be?
Like harnesses.
Shoes, ropes, gloves.
The harnesses.
The harnesses
and the carabiners.
Belay devices.
The big
carabiner.
The actual equipment, like the actual rock.
No, it's not
rock.
It's so sweet. My can't tell a story really fast.
Is it 3 seconds fast?
Yeah.
Okay, go.
Well, it's like a minute.
What?
Okay. So my uncle's like has like the highest certificate for climbing, and he took us to Utah and we went cliff rappelling. And it was super crazy.
So cool.
But I'd like lugged the rope around for like several miles, and it really sucked.
Wow. That was a good story. Thank you so much. All
right.
Thank you.
All right.
I could not have lived without that story.
So look at the member. He's paying $360 to start with, and then just $4 per day, just to rent the equipment. I guess it's the same as like the $6 for equipment that this guy pays, but he doesn't pay per day. He just pays
$360. All right.
Okay. Cool. Okay. So write an equation to find the number of visits after which the total cost of the member, the total cost of the non-member, is the same. Right? That's the same thing. It's the same thing. So let's talk about part A for the non-member. What's it cost a non-member?
10 to get in, 6 to rent.
Per
day.
Okay, so how do we write the equation? It's not just 10 plus 6, right? 10
times
x.
10 times x. Plus 6?
Times x.
Plus 6 times x. They're both times x.
Yeah.
They're both per day. Equals, how about for the member?
360.
X.
Plus
4x.
360x?
Plus 4x. 360x
plus
4x.
No.
Take the x off of 360.
Yeah.
My goodness.
360 plus 4x.
How ridiculous. $360 a day? Just one.
Just one.
Okay. So now we have an equation. Now we have a slightly different equation. We have like terms on one side. What can we do?
Mr. Shirt?
Yeah?
Is it low D high minus high D low or plus high D low?
It's minus.
Thank you.
I shouldn't have given that. Okay. So on this side we have like terms. Can we just, what can we do first? Up here.
You could
like group
together like terms.
Sure, so 16x?
Take
4x from both sides, 12x equals 360.
Then you divide
12 by 12, x equals 30.
Yeah.
31.
Yeah.
And what happens?
And then it equals the same as
the same.
Non-member.
At 30 days, the member and the non-member have paid the same total amount. The member went this way. You paid $360. Upfront, then $4 per day, and the non-member just paid $16 every day that they came.
But you labeled this a non-member.
What is it?
You labeled it non-member.
Yeah, non-member, a member. That's right. Part B. Make a table for the cost of members and non-members after 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35 visits. Ooh. Use the table to check your answers from part A.
My.
Lucky I have the. I'm sure it's somewhere. I don't have to write it on.
Is this the book?
This is the teaching position of the book. Where to see the margin? Where? Which margin? Where? Oh.
Oh.
3.4. 3.4. 52. There it is.
52 B. Bada bing, bada over.
Well, we know how to calculate for the non-members. We know how to calculate for the members, right? All we did was plug for the members' cost. This is what we use. We plug in 5, 360 plus 20, 380. Come over here. We plug in 5, 16 times 5, just $80. And we just keep doing the same for the members and non-members. We can see how the non-member is paying less. Still paying less. After 15 days, still paying less, paying less, paying less. But at 30 days, they're both paying the same exact amount. And then any days after that, the member is winning. He's the winner. The non-member is now paying more over time. That's all this chart is telling us. Jenna?
I'm just looking out my hair.
Like a thing.
Shedding.
Okay. There we go. Any questions? Whatever you do to solve the equation, just do something. If there's like terms to collect, if there's something to distribute, distribute it. If you're kind of clever, you can avoid the distributing by maybe dividing by the thing, and we'll find for the reciprocal, but only if it's helpful. Okay. Let me show you an example. Two different equations. 2 times x plus 7 equals 12. Right. I can distribute the two. That would be perfectly correct. I can divide by the two. Divide by two, and that worked out really nicely. X is negative one. Okay. How about this? Can I distribute the three?
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
3x.
What if I divide by three? Like I divided by two over here. I'm dividing by 3, what do you think? It's a good idea?
No.
It's not terrible, but what happens when I divide this side by 3? I get 17 thirds.
Yeah.
It's not divisible by 3. Here, 12 is divisible by 2, the even number is. That works out nicely. So, think about it. Or maybe, if you have 3 fifths, and x minus 12 equals 18, can you distribute the 3 fifths? Yes, you can. But maybe you should do what instead?
You should divide by it. No,
multiply by the reciprocal. That works out nicely, and it works nicely here too because the 3 does cancel at 18. X minus 12 equals 30, and we add 12, and x is 22. That was really nice and smooth. But if this guy does not get canceled by this 3, maybe we don't do that. Maybe we do distribute the direction.
Yeah.
See what happens. Right? Just do whatever is in line with all the mathematical laws that you know, with all the agreements that we've made when we're manipulating numbers. Follow those rules. If it works out, keep going. If it seems to be even worse, maybe back up. Try something else. Or maybe it's just bad. You just keep going. Power through. So let's pass in our homework and our pink slips. All right. It's a pretty simple one. I'm gonna just go. If you're confused at all, and you say, "Well, what did you just do?" Well, once you ask what you just do, I'll explain. 5x minus 5 equals -12. Plus 5, plus 5. Negative 7.
Five.
You got a cube. What's your cube?
What's that dot up there?
Oh, it was a screenshot and it just carried over from the other page. It's an F. It's this little guy right here.
Oh, a cube.
It was a cube. You got a cube or a cube. Alright, negative 7 fifths. What?
No, no, that's right, that's right. Can't you write a decimal?
I don't know, sure.
Yes.
Can you write a decimal?
I'm still putting 5 out of 5.
4x, negative x, they're like terms. I don't know why this is not really really unnecessary. 3x plus 3 equals 3x minus 5. Maybe that already seems kind of weird to you. I'm trying to get the variables on one side together. We get 3 equals negative 5. Will that ever be true?
No.
Are there any solutions?
No.
Yay.
Wow. Oh.
That's
my question.
Yeah,
that's
just
solve
no matter what, you know?
You just need to
do
it and then
it's
there.
Well,
yeah.
Can't do it. Can't
do it. Say that though.
I don't even.
Say solve the equation and you can tell me, well, there's no solution. Say it's unsolvable. I'm going to distribute 6x plus 10. You guys, I'm just going to go, and if you want the learning environment to be a little better, you're in control. 10 minus 6 is 4. 4x minus 7. I'm going to get all the variables together on one side. 2x plus 4. What did I do?
No, I'm just saying.
Let me
just draw a
red
down
for you. Good in here, good.
Minus
4. 2x equals negative 11. Divide by 2. 5.5. Maybe 5.5. Whatever.
Do you
want to
make that
so quickly? Is this question 3?
Yes.
That was number 2.
That one?
Oh, it's number 1 then.
The one with the cube.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay.
Distributing, here we go. 16x minus 32 plus 2 equals 3x minus 16. Combine these, so I'm going to do 16x minus 30 equals 3x minus 15. Let's put all the variables on one side together, or take 3 bags off this side, 3 bags off this side, is what we're doing. 13
bags on that.
That's right.
13.
Negative 15, add 30. 13x equals 15. Divide by 13. 15 over 13. If there's questions, ask. If not, finish it up, tally it. Yes?
What was answer to number 1?
Number 1, negative 7/5.
Yeah.
Negative
what,
7/5.
What was the, what would be the decimal?
You
want
to
four.
I like
that.
Are you
even
feeling like zero?
Something like x plus 2 equals 10. But how do we, so you know, what's the algebra?
So you say minus 2 on both sides.
Minus 2 on both sides. Minus 2, minus 2, that's what we do. Okay?
Dimitri?
Wow.
Your egg broke.
Dude,
no, it wasn't that
bad. I have 3.
Alright. Now, let's just make a simple substitution here so that you can see how simple this actually is. If I just threw this up at the beginning, you would think, you might think, how weird, how can I even handle it? But if I put something like x plus c, some other letter, equals 10, I would, this c, what does it represent?
Any number.
Any number.
Infinity.
Some
number.
It could be.
That it could
has infinite possibilities.
Zero.
But it doesn't represent infinity.
So infinity numbers that it could be.
Okay,
one.
Infinity numbers can add. So, it represents some number, like 2, like 2, right? Similar to 2. But whatever that number is, how are we going to get x by itself?
Subtract 2.
We're going to subtract, just like we did subtract 2, we're going to subtract
c from both sides.
C from both sides. And what's 10 minus c? It's just 10 minus c. There's nothing else.
No.
What's 10 c mean?
Ten times.
This is not 10 times. This is 10.
You
minus
can multiply
times.
Letters now.
There's this like in your hearts, you want to be able to cram two numbers together. It happens all the time. Like 10 plus c is 10c, but it's not the same thing. 10 plus c is 10 plus c. 10 C's.
And what page is this?
This is 3.8. I don't know the page, but I'm off the top of my head. 3.8. Alright. So all we're doing is we're going to throw letters in there, other letters. But remember, those letters, they just represent numbers. So it makes algebra algebra. And we're going to manipulate those letters like we would any other number. Because that's what they represent. They represent numbers. They act like numbers. They just don't combine with numbers nicely. Like when you subtract C from 10, you just have 10 minus C. I don't know what C is. C is just a placeholder. I can't do this until I know what C is. Okay? And you may never know in the case of this section. So,
wait, so that would just be the answer.
That's it. X is by itself. X is 10 minus C. X is worth whatever 10 minus C is worth.
So, you probably can't do this, but if you could do it on the scale, what would it look like?
The scale?
Like
the number line?
No, like the...
Oh!
Yeah.
We would have, like, two different looking bags, maybe two different colors. Okay, so like this will be X, and this will be C, and I don't want to imply that C is bigger or smaller than X, so I won't make the size different, but I'll just go ahead and change the color to green. Okay, so that, the different color represents that they're different amounts, probably. So X plus C is equal to 10. I have to subtract C from both sides. That's like taking one of these, right, and making it filled with helium, like the opposite. It's hard to draw an analogy here, but making it float up like this so that it, well, floating up then pushing down, they cancel each other out, right? And so but I also need to subtract C from this side. So whatever 10 minus C is, that's what X is about. Yeah, it's weird. The analogy's not perfect in that case. Let me just give you one to work on yourself. See what you come up with. How about 2x minus d equals 5. So you should come up with. Alright, so just like if this was 2x minus 7 equals 5, you do the exact same thing. Okay, so what would be something we could do first? I got Dimitri was really emphatic.
So you plus D on both sides. You add D, sorry.
Add D. Is negative D plus D, is that?
Put each other out.
They cancel each other out, it's zero. Add D to both sides, 2x equals 5 plus D.
And then you divide 2.
Divide by 2, that's what you would do. If D were some number, right? If it was minus 7, you add 7, you'd have 7 plus 5 is 12, and you divide by 2. It's just that we don't know what D is, so it's just a placeholder for now. We divide by 2, we divide both sides by 2. X equals 5 plus D divided
5
by 2.
5.
Perfect.
Looks like that's me.
That's the greatest.
I like your ringtone.
You feel like I'm playing DDR.
DDR.
Okay, is that a reference anybody knows?
No.
Is that like old
like
retro?
Can you tell us what it is
now? Retro? No, it's Dance Dance Revolution.
Yeah. Oh, I had that as a child. Do you actually play it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I love this.
Yeah,
and
I was like,
about
oh,
okay. Okay.
I was the best.
Let's keep it going.
I
have
the Disney version.
X, how about M times X, plus...
That's why you're just
people
just
me.
M times X.
M times X. That's right.
Equals R.
Equals R, yeah, equals the letter R.
Yes.
Oh my god.
All we're trying to do is get X by itself.
No, yeah.
Isolate X on one side. Okay? Opening bit. Guessing?
Subtract S.
Subtract F. F minus F is 0.
5.
M, X equals whatever R minus F is worth. good.
Ready?
Divide by M, yeah. If that was a 5 or 12 or negative 3, you'd be dividing by it right now, so divide by M. Whatever R minus F divided by M is, that's X.
Is that the, like, the homework entirely, just that?
Basically, it's like solving equations, but there's other letters in there instead of just all numbers.
No, it's kind of
simple.
No
big deal.
So
we're
gonna
do now, about one more, and something like, does that look like a formula you've seen before?
Yeah, that's
on the quiz. Fahrenheit,
Celsius.
That's
Celsius.
Yes. Centigrade. Oh, not quite. Not quite.
It's close.
And it's not 9/5, it's 5/9. And this is in parentheses. Now, this one, if I know F, Fahrenheit, I can plug it in, and it tells me Celsius. But what if I have Celsius, I don't know Fahrenheit. I want the equation to, the formula to work the other way. I want to have F by itself on one side.
That means you go.
So I'm going to get F by itself on one side. Dimitri?
Plus.
Let's
do the 9 property.
Distributive. Would everybody distribute this 5/9?
No, they wouldn't.
What about the
reciprocal?
Multiply by the reciprocal idea. 5/9 times C on that side. Now 5/9 times C equals F minus 32. And? Last thing?
Plus 32.
Plus 32. 5/9 C equals F minus 32.